question for Clarissa. I wanted to backpedal a little bit to the commentating question earlier. I know this is all things boxing chat, but some of my friends were wondering over the weekend during the fights, I don't know if anyone watched it, but they felt like the commentators were trying to talk Israel into the fight when he was clearly down. Do you feel like they do that in women's boxing and in boxing? That the commentators kind of talk up one fighter and, you know, talk down the other one?
I mean, I think that they're allowed to pick who they want to pick, but I also feel like sometimes they don't, I think it's just a personal thing for them. Like, they pick who they want to pick. Like, okay, we're going for this guy, so we're going to talk him. But usually they try to have it to where, okay, you're going. Hi, how you doing? Thank you, girl. I gave you a shout out on my page. Okay. Yeah, no problem. But I know that they always try to have, you know, pick people to do, like, okay, we're going to go for this person and go for that person. That's how it's supposed to be, but sometimes it don't really go like that. But they do like the bigger fighters, because somebody was telling me that that the commentators was kind of bigging me up during my fight. And I had said, well, it's kind of hard to go against me, but I've had commentators that went against me when I fought against Hammer, you know, and they were saying, like, oh, you know, she had the remedy to beat me.
Yeah.
So it's really all about personal opinion. And they don't, and the networks don't make them pick who they have to go, like, who they have to go for. They kind of just let them free ball it and they pick who they want. So,
man, they was just doing that shit in this fight you just had. They was talking, like, you whooping this girl ass the whole fight. They up there talking about how, like, the girl's so solid and resilient and she can take shots. Like, man, she getting her ass whooped. Y'all trying to make her sound like she doing something good. She just taking the ass beating. Then she holding like
oh, my God, she was holding.
Like, come on, man.
Yeah, they do that shit. I didn't even get mad about the holding, because it's like I get held every fight, and I ask all of the refs in the back, you know, what do you guys do about holding? They all give me some bullshit answer. And I just kind of be like, all right, because, you know, you don't want to get on the ref's bad side before you fight anyway. But I just be like, you know, if it was me doing the excessive holding, they would fucking take all kind of points from me. But I just thought after she held me and forearmed me for the third time, right, I thought maybe he would have told her, like, hey, one more time and I'm going to take a point. He never told her that, but I mean, she held the whole fight.
Right.
Yeah, she was tripping for real.
I was like, dang, is she in love or what? Like, what?
Everybody kept saying, they were like, yo, she's a professional hugger. I was just trying
to know that. So, on the issue of fouls, would you say that your toughest opponent was one that committed the most fouls or the least?
My toughest opponent, to me, when I think about my toughest opponent, I think about somebody who want to win just as bad as I do. And I can sense when a girl know that she's losing and she just fighting back, and that's the Hannah Gabriel. And I know when it's a girl who feel like the fight is close and we both been there fighting our ass off, and that's the Franton Cruz. So Franton Cruz was my hardest fight, because we both just had so much grit and we hit each other with some real hard shots.
Yeah.
And even though we got a lot of love for each other, but I was trying to end her ass. She was trying to end me too. So we was definitely going at it for our pro debuts, and that was my toughest fight to date.
Wow.
I got a question for Clarissa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, it's first of all, to all the women, happy Women's International
thank
Women's
you.
Month. You know what I'm saying? Respect thank to you, all the women. You feel me? This is some off-brand question, you know, just really about your perception on boxing and about just two fights that potentially could happen. You know, I would like to know if you can, if you want to answer the question, who you like in, you know, Spence versus Bud, and also who you like in Benavidez versus Charlo, if you would like to answer this question.
For Earl Spence and Bud, I don't ever pick a winner out of them two, because they both like my family and I love both of them.
I figured you was gonna say that.
I always say, let the best man win, and I'll be there talking about some, y'all go, both of y'all do y'all thing. Yeah. And just, hey, how you doing? Hey, I recognize y'all, how y'all doing? Hey,
man, no pictures,
she can't go a champion right of the people. I love it. A champion
no pictures,
of the people.
No pictures, man.
Yeah, man.
My old buddy up there. That's yeah, y'all remember. Yeah. Yep. Y'all have a good one. Yeah, so I was No, so then you asked me about Charlo and Benavidez.
Yeah.
And I think Benavidez throw a lot of punches to be as big as he is.
Yeah.
But I just think that Charlo is a dog, for real. I think it'll be a dog fight.
I agree. Charlo
and
is
I would
winning.
Love to see. Yeah, and I just want to see, like. 50-50. Yeah, it is a 50-50 fight, but I think that Charlo got the more experience. He fought against the better fighters.
And David got a bad gas.
Yeah.
He gonna work hard for that fight. And I know that Benavidez is hungry as hell right now, but
I'm telling you.
To me, I still look at him like, you know, he ain't green, but he's still kind of new in the game, and I love to see him face better opponents before they start saying that he's on a level to fight against like Charlo. But I still love to see that fight right now though, because he's young, he's hungry, he's gonna make mistakes. Charlo make mistakes and they be in there throwing some bombs at each other. So
I just love
to see it.
All right, appreciate that.
So I have a question for you, Clarissa. Can I ask it?
Mm-hmm, go ahead.
So first of all, thank you for your time. I was just wondering, like, I'm a boxer and I want to have my first fight soon. And I'm already very nervous for my fight. And I was just wondering, like, how do you deal with the nerves?
I'm Clarissa. How you doing? Yeah. Thank you. I can hear you. I'm on a phone call. Yep. Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it. Hello. I probably beeped out.
It's okay. You can start again.
Of course. No, so he said he was just starting boxing. He had a pro fight, nervous, something.
Yeah, like, how do you deal with the nerves? And do you still have nerves? Like, I want to have my first fight very soon, and I'm training very hard for it, and I'm really nervous for it already. And I was just wondering, like, how do you deal with nerves, and do you still have nerves, like, after so much experience?
I think when I'm in the ring consistently, I really don't have nerves. Like, when I'm in the ring consistently, like, every 3 months, every 4 months, I'm getting inside the ring. I kind of try to enjoy the moment of it. But I think for this fight, I wasn't nervous about my opponent. I was nervous about, you know, how my body is going to box after being out the ring for 13 months. So I would say for your first fight, just if you ask me for some advice what to do for your nerves, drink some cold water when you get to the fight. Take as many deep breaths as you can and pay attention to your pacing. Like, if you waste the energy pacing back and forth and you're breathing hard, just force yourself to, okay, calm down. It's just a fight, and just remind yourself, like, you want to do this, right? Like, you shouldn't be nervous to do something that you want to do. If you don't want to do it, then don't do it. But if you, like, okay, I've been training hard, and I'm training to win, you really shouldn't let the nervous energy get to you, because it'll throw you off. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, this is what you want to do. And know that and can't nobody help your opponent, not the ref, not his coach or team. It's just you and whoever your opponent is. So don't be nervous. It's just a fight, and go out there and do what you want to do.
Appreciate that. Thank you.
That was great.
Yeah. I got a question for Clarissa. I just want to know, like, you've been dominating in the women's sport boxing for a minute, and I see you got interest in MMA. I just would like to know when you can see yourself going to that.
I had my first MMA fight in June.
Okay,
this year.
I gotta look that up.
I fight for the PFL league. I'll be fighting at 155 pounds. So yeah,
man, that's awesome.
Yeah, and we will be doing a watch party for that too. It's not all things boxing, but since Clarissa Shields is going over there, it is all things boxing. So we will be doing a watch party and promoting that for you.
What about those leg kicks, Clarissa?
The only exception.
Yes,
I'm doing everything. I'm gonna go in there and use all my offensive tools for sure.
Has it helped you working with Cyborg?
I only sparred against Cyborg in boxing. We didn't do any MMA training when I went down there. It was, I think, to help her with boxing more than anything.
Oh, so you haven't cross trained with MMA with her?
Nope, I did cross training with Holly Holm. Some training with Johnny Bones.
That's a good one. Yeah, fire.
Okay.
I love Holly. Love
in the past. In the past,
I'm a big fan of John Jones. Is he as savage as he seems in person?
Yes, fucking definitely. Yeah.
Like, that guy chased down somebody with a shotgun and his dog.
Yeah, Johnny Bones not to be fucked with, trust me.
So